Hi, I'm Rebecca. I'm a fourth year dental student and these are my top tips for interview. Number one, take your time. It can be really tempting to just jump straight in with an answer, but most interview questions are about experiences that you've had or qualities about yourself, and so it's really important that you take the time to make sure you're offering the best example of whatever it is that you've been asked. It also shows the interviewers that you are the type of person who thinks before you speak, and that's a really important quality to have. Number two, read around current events or interesting topics in medicine or dentistry that genuinely interest you, because that passion will shine through when you are speaking, and in these professions we need people who are passionate about what they do. And number three, be yourself and enjoy the interview for what it is, which sounds silly to say, but you are more than just a set of correct answers from an interview prep book. You are an individual, and these people have asked you to come to interview because they like what they see in you. From my own experience, the best clinical students are the ones that have a good rapport with their clinical teachers. So if you can show that you're capable of creating that rapport inside the interview room, then now's the time to do that.
Hi, my name's Andrew, and I'm one of the final year medical students. I think when it comes to interviews, one of the key things to remember is that everyone's nervous. I know I was certainly nervous, and I'm sure yourself, you will be nervous too. This is completely normal. The examiners are well aware of it. I'm sure they've had interviews in their life and they've been nervous for them too. And almost it's expected to be nervous. It shows that it's something that you care about. It shows that it's something you're passionate about. And I think it's important to try to use them nerves, to use that adrenaline rush to sort of give you that little boost that you need so to get through the interview. As well as the nerves, I think a key thing to remember as well is that every station is unique from the last station you did. So the examiner is saying station 4 has never seen you before. So if in station 3, for example, you didn't quite perform as well as you would have liked to have performed, that's all right. Move on to station 4, forget what happened in station 3 and just give it your best shot. Sometimes if one station knocks you, that can carry you throughout all of the stations. It's important to make sure that you don't let that happen, and that's very similar to a lot of the exams you have in medical school, where it'll sort of be like 10 stations back to back. You want to go from one to the other, and if you don't do as well in one, that's fine. You know, you haven't got to get 100%. You've just got to do the best you can do, and hopefully that's good enough. I'm sure it will be. Good luck. Thanks very much.
Hi, my name's Sarah and I'm in my second year of dentistry at Newcastle Uni. So my top tips for interview would be to make sure you're super smiley and super chatty, because the interviewer will be looking for your personality to come through. Also, during interview preparation, I'd advise you take your personal statement and with a highlighter, highlight all the key points that you've mentioned. Things like work experience, or if you play any sport or a musical instrument, or any volunteering you've done. Highlight this and then form your own questions. So things like, why have you decided to volunteer? Or what skills have you learned from the sport you play or the musical instrument you play, and why is it important for the course that you want to study? Make sure you don't brush over the simple questions, things like why dentistry or medicine, or why this specific uni, because these do come up at interviews, so make sure you're prepared for them.
I'm a fifth year dental student. I'm just going to be giving you a few top tips for an interview. So the first thing I would say is definitely don't pre-prepare all your answers word for word. Get some bullet points down, get a general idea for questions that come up quite a lot. So questions about why you want to be a dentist, not a medic, or the other way around. But don't pre-prepare them, because they can definitely tell and they'd rather see how you get to improvise anyway. Another thing I would say is, if you need a little bit of time to think about a question, that's absolutely fine. They'll expect that, and they'd probably appreciate the fact you're thinking about your answer, and it'll make your answer better in the long run. Another thing I would say is, if you don't know the answer to a question, especially in an MMI situation, that's absolutely fine. Just talk through your thinking, and then they'll appreciate that as well. It's better than just not saying anything or saying something that's a load of rubbish or pretending that you know the answer. They're more bothered about how you cope under pressure than your actual answer. And finally, I would say be yourself. Don't say anything or exaggerate anything that might not be true. Try and keep to yourself and enjoy yourself as much as you can, and try and put a smile on your face. Okay, thanks.